No mai hare mai ki te whareparamata e Aotearoa.
Hello and welcome to the Parliament Buildings in Wellington.
Here in New Zealand we get a lot of earthquakes because the country sits on top of two tectonic plates.
Wellington, the capital city, lies within the earthquake zone between these two plates, sitting on top of some major fault lines.
In fact, one of these fault lines is only 400 metres from the Parliament Buildings.
The Parliamentary Library and Parliament House weren't designed to withstand a major earthquake, and by the 1980s, the foundations of both buildings were showing signs of deterioration.
Under New Zealand law, both the Parliamentary Library and Parliament House require permanent protection, so there were concerns about the impact an earthquake would have.
In 1989, the New Zealand government decided to strengthen and refurbish the buildings.
The three-year strengthening project began in 1992. The idea was to separate Parliament House and Parliamentary Library from their original foundations and place them on lead rubber bearings, or base isolators.
This would mean the building sits on very solid foundations, yet isolated from most of the ground movement during an earthquake.
This project also saw the creation of the Galleria. Supporting walls were added within Parliament House to prevent twisting movements during an earthquake.
The Galleria used to be used as an internal car park and was twice as wide.
The original foundations were exposed, so access holes could be drilled. A horizontal saw removed slices of the original foundations, separating the buildings from their base, which left the entire structure resting on the base isolators.
417 base isolator bearings were positioned within the existing foundation under Parliament House and the Parliamentary Library.
Each base isolator consists of alternate layers of high-density rubber and steel plates with an inner core of lead.
During an earthquake, the energy generated by the shaking causes the lead to soften and absorb movement. This allows the bearings to move up to 30 centimetres in any horizontal direction.
This means the buildings themselves move much less, and there is less risk of damage to the buildings or injury to the people in them.
Here you can see how Parliament House reacted during the 2016 Kakuta earthquake. At its epicentre, the earthquake measured 7.8 on the Richter scale. The Parliamentary Library and Parliament House sustained no major structural damage, unlike a number of other buildings in Wellington.
The base isolation system was developed by Wellington engineer Dr. Bill Robinson.
This technology is used throughout New Zealand in places like Wellington Hospital, Te Papa and the Stadium.
And also in places around the world like San Francisco City Hall in the United States and Burj Hospital in India.
So if you're ever in Wellington, come to Parliament and take a tour.
To find out more, visit the Parliament website. We hope to see you again soon. Hei kone rā.